எது எப்படி இருப்பினும் கர்ணஞ்சய வாழ்ந்தவர்களே கருத்துல அளிக்காது.
Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. Today I'm going to give you a brief overview of the Sri Lankan Civil War and share my thoughts about the war and how it has affected me as a Tamil British citizen. I will also give a brief overview of my father's book, Vattukottiyil Irundhu Mulivaikkum Varai, towards the end. The tropical island of Sri Lanka has attracted visitors for centuries with its natural beauty, but has been scarred by a long and bitter civil war arising out of ethnic tensions between the Sri Lankan government and the Tamil rebels. After more than a quarter of a century, the conflict ended in May 2009, when government seized the last area controlled by the Tamil Tiger rebels. As a result, an estimated 80,000 to 100,000 people between 1982 and 2009 were killed. The deaths included more than 30,000 Tamil fighters, more than 20,000 Sri Lankan soldiers, more than 1,000 Sri Lankan police, 1,500 Indian soldiers, and tens of thousands of civilians. Most of us here in this room today were all affected by the civil war, including myself. I've lost many dear relatives during this civil war. Before I was even born, my father's brother has lost his life during the civil war, to whom this book is in memory of. Although I've never seen him, let alone known him, I still sympathize heavily for him because I have two younger brothers and cannot imagine the emotional pain I would feel if I lost either of them at a young age. When I was 10, I remember running downstairs as soon as I heard the sound of my mother's crying. With one hand, she held a clear photograph of her cousin's family, a family of four, mother and three children, who've also been killed during the Civil War, and the other she used to wipe the continuous flow of tears running down her face from her eyes. Seeing my mom cry makes me cry. It's simply human nature. This family was killed after a bomb has been dropped on top of a bunker where they have been sheltered to save their lives. They are just civilians. They had no interference with the war, but had still lost their lives. When I was 9, I remember seeing my dad cry after hearing the news of his cousin brother's death during the Civil War. I see my father as a strong man. I never seen him cry before in my lifetime. This just goes to show how strong and powerful the impact of war really is. It not only impacts on those who are killed or injured, but also on their dear relatives and friends. Moving on, let's talk about why we are all here today, which is to celebrate the launch of my father's new book, Vattukottiyil Irundhu Mulivaikkum Varai. As you all may know, Vattukottiyil is where it all happened, where it all started, where Tamil political leaders declared to pursue for their own independent state, known as the Tamil Eelam. This happened in 1976. And Mulivaikkum is where it all ended, where the infamous leader of the Tamil Tigers was killed, although there is some controversy about this topic. Therefore, if we put two and two together, we know that my father's book is based on the events which took place from the very beginning to the very end, the entire Civil War. However, my father mentioned that the book heavily focuses on the last years of the war, the 2008 and 2009 period. This appeared to be the bloodiest and most brutal period of the Civil War, where most of the killings and battles have been taken place, including the Battle of Kilnochie. Over 20,000 to 40,000 civilians were killed in this period alone. Not to mention, this is the period where most of the articles were written, in the book were written. And also the relatives I mentioned before, they've all died in this period. Before I finish off, let me talk to you about the problems we are now facing today. As a young person myself, I am aware that we have more things going on through our lives. We have work, studies, social life, and etc. But we are also being ignorant about politics. It's important that we spare some time to news and politics because we will always be the ones that are heavily impacted. I feel that young people like me need to be more aware of politics, not only to understand what's going on, but to also change the future. Finally, my personal thoughts on this war. My personal thoughts on this war, most wars in general, are that it's pointless and absurd. There are no better words to use. The LTT's main objective was to fight for their own independent state, but in the end, they didn't even achieve that. And even if they did achieve it, is it worth sacrificing the tens of thousands of lives? Was it worth all the 25 years of horror the entire Sri Lankan population had to face? There is never a reason to war. There are always other methods of resolving conflict. Some say war must be used as a last resort. I disagree. There is never a reason to war. If matters cannot be solved for better, at least don't make it worse. Leave the way things are. War only makes things worse. In addition, what angers me the most about the war is that it undermines the value of human life. One human life has so much value. The human life contains precious memories, experiences, friends and family, and these were all lost during one war. And that is all I have left to say. Thank you all for listening to my speech. I hope you will enjoy the rest of the event.
நன்றி கருணா.